What's up, everybody? 627 update is here. Things are a little bit different than we actually thought we're going to be in the 627 update. The first time I read this update, I started freaking out because I read something a little bit differently than it actually was. And I was like, oh my God, this is going to make everyone do Arena again. I may have jumped the gun on that one. Okay, so let's go take a look at what 627 update is, because I think a lot of people are going to make the same assumption as what I thought when I first read it, so we can clarify that a little bit, right? 627 has been updated. Please check below for details, yada, yada. Arena improvement, the amount of glory points you earn when winning an arena match has been increased as follows. Everything is increased, bumped up to one extra point, which they've been doing. They did maybe like 6 months ago or 9 months ago or something like that. They did a thing where there's like the arena tiers now, where like whatever you get from the previous week, you're in a certain bracket, and then if you do really good that week, you know, you get more extra glory points, basically. So this is just allowing newer players to get more glory points faster, right? If you're end game, it's really not that relevant. Well, I mean, it's still kind of relevant. You just make sure you get all the scrolls per week, right? And then the same thing, this is just for arena rivals, the little NPCs that you have. Shop arena glory point building improvement. So the first time I read this, I was like, oh my God, this is going to make everyone have to do arena, because I saw this maximum level of all glory buildings has been increased from level 10 to level 20. And I was like, holy crap, that means everyone's going to have to spam arena to upgrade the speed tower as much as possible, upgrade the attack tower, the crit damage tower even more, the HP tower, the defense tower, all these stats. We're going to need to upgrade all these to get our stats even higher than ever before. It's going to be crazy. People are going to be rushing arena like, well, maybe not rushing, but like arena rush hour. They're just going to be farming arena throughout the week. This is not quite as what it looks like here, right? You can upgrade the buildings and change. I mean, it is upgrading them to from 10 to 20, right? All of this stuff from 10 to 20. And then it's also max upgrade cost is actually being decreased for all of this stuff. So this really helps. If we take a look at this max upgrade cost, this really helps people that don't have their towers upgraded to the max yet, right? So that's great for them. Everyone that already has their towers upgraded doesn't really, you know, it's irrelevant to you. It looks like we're going to be like, oh, what, we get all these extra stats from being level 20 now. It is not quite the same. Max level 20 building effects of all buildings of the Sanctum of Energy will be the same as previous maximum level 10 effects. So the new level 20 building effects are the same as the previous level 10 effects. So they're not going to be extra stats. Is just making it more levels to get there with a lower cost in between levels. So it's gonna so new players can feel more progression faster. At first I thought we were actually getting more stats for everyone, and I was freaking out, and yeah. They got this little asterisk over here, like, oh, by the way, you don't get extra stats. You are excited about nothing. Thank you, come to us. Thank you for making me excited about nothing. So anyway, now we have, if we can see right here, Ancient Sword level 7 attack plus 14%. Now is level 14 attack plus 14%. Same exact attack increase percentage-wise. But from level 14, level 7, your tower would have said level 7 before. Now it's going to say level 14, right? So everyone's got tower level 10. After the patch, you're going to have tower level 20. That's it. And it just makes it seem like It's just a easier progression to digest for newer players, right? So this way you get, like, because before it was like a ton of glory points that you would have to need to get to like that 8, 9, 10 level. But now it's like it's going to be half that, but you're going to have to do twice the amount of levels. So I hope I am explaining correctly. I'm probably not. Level of Sanctum of Energy you possess will not be changed after 627 update. So they are just changing all of this Sanctum of Energy, as you can see. All the Sanctum of Energy changes. Guild improvement. Oh, so there's also guild improvements, which I forgot to mention. Did I forget to mention? I don't know. Amount of energy used to enter one battle decreased from 10 to 5. Guild battle, you can now edit the defense members. Because they did mention this, they did foreshadow this in the talk that they had with the Korean guilds, the devs had with the Korean guilds. You cannot edit during the tallying period. The number of members participating was set initially when registering for the guild battle on Sunday, cannot be modified, etc., etc., right? But you can still edit the defense members at any time during the week, which is nice if you run a of course, it's nice if you run a guild, because sometimes midweek someone's like, oh, I would like to enter guild battle. Or I would like, well, actually, you could change that. You just have to stop the auto start. So anyway, no, wait. You could change the attack. You could change the members that are going to attack, but you couldn't change the defense. So now you can change the defense during midweek. Anyway, moving on. I could just read this instead of trying to talk myself in circles, right? Activity info menu where you can see the details of guild member activities at a glance has been added. Oh my god, people are going to see how little guild content I actually do. That's not good. Baker, you always do Guild War videos. Yeah, but that doesn't mean to the Guild Wars that aren't off videos. If it's not on video, I don't do them. Crap, I shouldn't be admitting to that on camera. 1 month cycle activity information will be recorded up to 12 months. Activity information for... This is hardcore, man. People are going to get kicked for that. I'm going to get kicked for my own guild. I'm scared of that. Well, I mean, I can't, technically. They'll find a way to do it. Guild. So this is for guild flags. This is just changing the guild flags. Again, it's kind of the same thing as for the arena towers. And by the way, guys, the arena tower, if you're early game, you don't know. Arena towers apply to everywhere. Guild flags are only for guild content. Arena towers are for everywhere. So arena towers, much more significant, much more important than the guild towers. So just FYI. But yeah, all this stuff is going to be the number. Again, the number is just going to be increased, but it's not going to increase your stats. It's a bummer. I was very excited for when I thought it was going to increase the stats, right? And then it's easier for people to completely max them. So this is stuff that's actually exciting and not a tease. Weekly special item we get free. Legendary pieces, not bad. Special item number one, the new 7-year scrolls, right? That's not bad. You can get up to 20 and you can use five. That's the 7-year, yeah, 7-year seals. 5 7-year seals for each of them. So that's going to be 100 7-year seals. Special item two, you get some Devilmons, 2 Devilmons, extra Devilmons. It's not bad. I really wish they would add some 4-star Devilmons in. I really wish they would do that, right? And then also, just to note, you can use 7-year seals, blah, blah, blah. 7-year seals can be obtained from the 7th year anniversary and as battle drop rewards. So just farm. That's all you gotta do. So this next part is the same exact thing. It's just showing you more in detail of the things that we get from here. Like, as you see, there's a special item number one. I actually messed this up. The special item number one is not one scroll. It is 5 scrolls. 7-year special scroll, 5 scrolls. 50,000 mana. And this is for 5 7-year seals. So yeah, 50,000 mana, 5 scrolls, and that's for the 5 seals. So that's actually a pretty good value, 5 seals, right? And then we have Devilmons. We said, like I said, it's just the same things as up here. Same exact things. It's just showing more in detail. Awakening Force. We've got to see the Awakening Force. Or sorry, Forbidden Evolution scroll and the Awakening Force, which we're gonna have for 20 7-year seals. We got a legendary artifact. I don't get that excited about legendary artifacts, to be honest. I don't even care. Is 20 7-year seals for a legendary artifact? You just get them from farming. I mean, like, that's not that hard to get them from farm. Anyway, Super Angelmon, Reappraisal Stone, Ancient Coins. Ancient Coins would be nice for the people that are hoping to get the Shadow, or that are looking to get the Shadow Claw, right? Purchase limited to 6 times. Decent amount of Ancient Coins there. 4-star Rainbow Mons, I don't care about that. 5-star Rainbow Mons, purchase limited up to 2 times. So that's 40% of a nat 40% of 6-starring monster right there. XP booster, unknown scrolls, mana scrolls. So there's some garbage here, right? I think the ancient coins are nice. I like the 5-star Rainbow Mons are okay. And then Summon Stones, that's a decent amount of Summon Stones, right? And then Devil Mons, and then these scrolls. Those are the ones that I am the most excited about. Following items can be claimed once a week and purchased with crystals, like a crystal shop. We've seen this before. Was it a Christmas crystal shop? Crystalmas Christmas shop? 7-year special scroll times 7 for 300 crystals. Which is basically, I mean, if you think about it, they're the equivalent of... I mean, they're better than mystical scrolls, obviously, but they're like the equivalent of mystical scrolls. So mystical scrolls would be... 4, 7 of those would be, oh my god, I don't know, math of 7. More than 300 crystals. More than 300, it would be 525 crystals worth. So this is for 300, that's an easy pick that up, of course. LD scroll for 350 crystals. I'd rather get the 7 special. I don't know. It's still Summoner's War. 6-star legendary rune, random type and number. Kind of a bummer, right? Reappraisals, though. Reappraisals, 2 reappraisals there. I feel like the reappraisal. Actually, I know for a fact the reappraisal is the more exciting thing than the legend rune. You get legend rune. You can get a legend rune in it. You know, you farm Dragon's B12 10 times. You'll get a legend rune, or like 20 times, you'll get a legend rune. You'll just sell it because it's not the one that you want. So the reappraisals are actually the most valuable thing in this, not the legendary rune, because it's a random one, right? Just completely random. You don't get to choose the slot. You don't get to choose the set. 7-year special scroll over here. That's a these are each week, by the way. Each week. Some of them are not as good as others. Some of them are not as good as others. But yeah, more special scrolls. Another Devilmon here for 350 crystals and 4 rainbow. That's still, I mean, Devilmon, but it's expensive for a Devilmon, 350 crystals. Some of these are not as good value as I kind of want them to be. And then attribute scrolls, and then 7-year. The 7-year special scrolls are better than the attribute scrolls, and they're also cheaper. Firewall already. Yeah, I mean, people are going to buy these regardless, but some of these are not that exciting, to be honest. Some of these are not that exciting. I mean, reaps are exciting, Devilmons are exciting, 7-year special scrolls are exciting, but we know they're mostly going to be 3-stars. The nice part about it is that we're probably not going to get too many 5-stars out of them because you know the rates are not good. But 4-stars that you're looking for skill ups for, right? Like if you're looking for Onimusha skill ups, that's going to be nice. So, we see a little bit more about the 7-year anniversary. You cannot use these with blessings, by the way. So, just FYI. And then the Dark Ifrit is getting his modification here. We also have some RTA stuff. A monster will be summoned in unawakened form. Collab monster, Shadow Claw, Ifrit, Cowgirl, 5-star fusion monsters cannot be included in the list, which we kind of would have assumed anyway, right? It's not anything too shocking, but you can't use blessings with those. And then we have Season 17. We get an Incarnation of Destruction Monkey King and a Swaying Magical Flow. That's going to be cool. And a Volcanic Lava Flying Dragon. You can't make a Bikini Dragon, seriously? Come to us. We just want one Bikini Dragon. That's all we're asking for. They're not going to do it. That would have been so much fun if they did that, right? This is interesting as well. Block list. You can block people. You know all those people saying really toxic, terrible, terrible, terrible things in chat? You can just block them over here. That's going to be great, right? Summoners who are blocked from the chat will now be added to the block list, and the block summoners for chat message, guild megaphone, raid invitation, other chat-related content will not be displayed. So, I mean, you could have blocked them before anyway, but it's just we get a block list. So they still have a lot of extra guild stuff to change, though. This is just like the small amount of like guild things that are changed. Not really too much. And again, and then UI improvement. So this is a new UI improvement for the thing. But initially, the first time I saw this, I was very excited because I thought we were getting extra stats for all our towers. And it was not that, which is kind of a bummer, and I really wish it would, because I think that people would be bummed out. Endgame players would be bummed out because they're like, I don't want to farm arena now. I thought I was past that. I thought I was just letting these new plebs farm arena, and they would have to farm arena again. But yeah, we don't have any new and any extra stats. So there are some improvements. Definitely helps for newer players to catch up, which is what they've been doing slowly but surely throughout the years. And then we have those shops, and we have some little guild improvements, right? The shops. Half of these are not that exciting. The other half are kind of exciting or kind of good, right? Anyway, that's it for this one. I just wanted to let you guys know. Just wanted to go over this little update. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I will see you, as always, in the next one.